So there's a question that someone posted the other day, and it's been on my mind ever since. What if when we get to heaven, God is like, "So, how was hell?" Kaboom. Today we're going to be doing another advice video. Welcome back to my channel. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'm glad you're here. If you're new, hit the subscribe button. Turn your post notifications on. If you're not new and you're back again, thanks for joining me in my space. Thank you. Greatly appreciate it. Leave a like and share it with your friends so your friends can know me too and we can know each other. You know, I have my blue book. I take my notes in because my memory, maybe not my memory, my focus be off. So, today's advice video is going to be how to come out of your shell. Also, so my makeup was heavily inspired by the 60s. But yeah, I was trying something new. When it comes to makeup, I love the 60s makeup, the mod look. So I went with the mod, you know, the y'all see. And I normally don't wear like nude anything. The most I'll do is like a brown lipstick. But my mom was like, when you do 60s, you have to do a nude or a pink lip. So I went with the nude lip. So yeah, if you guys want a video on this look, please let me know. So yeah, today's video is going to be how to come out of your shell. Now, being a person who has anxiety, I'm going to tell y'all, it's not easy because this is something that I still deal with anytime I go out because I'm used to just being in my room. So when I go out, it's like, oh my gosh, the awkward turtle has emerged. And it's like, the first thing, figure out what and where your comfort zone is. This will help lead you in the right direction of what to do. So, for example, with me, my comfort zone is being at home, in my room, in my bed. If I'm in a social setting, I am more comfortable when I'm with people that I know. And if I don't know anyone there, it often like makes me draw back. So what I started to do as of last year sometime, I would go to events and whether or not I knew people there, I would just go. Most of the time when I went to events, people would be like, oh, you're here by yourself? And I'm like, yeah. Do you know anybody here? And I'm like, no. Like, after a while, the more events I started to go to, it would teach me how to communicate better, especially in person, because obviously social media, we will think that we have great communication skills because we know how to text, but when it comes to seeing people in person and communicating with someone else in person, it's totally different. So going to events definitely helped me as far as picking up tips on communication and how to really get back out there and put myself out there and really talk to people about my interests and hear the interests of others. And you build friendships that way. Like, I've met a lot of people, made some really good friendships in the last year just by going to these events, whether it was in a group or by myself. Mostly by myself, but you get the gist. So that was the first tip. Figure out what your comfort zone is and then figure out ways to combat that. So I'm going to give another example. If your comfort zone is when you go to an event, right, or you go to a party, you hug the wall. Hugging the wall is cool, like if you're just trying to like observe real quick and feel out the room and feel out the energy, But like once more people are starting to interact, it makes you seem less approachable. So you want to make it so that people feel like they could come talk to you, even if you are by yourself and they can tell that you're shy. It'll make you seem more approachable. I'm gonna shout one of my friends out here. His Instagram is Sir Cozy. Whenever he does an event, he will tell people, get off the wall. Like, you're not robots. Talk to people, hug the person next to you, introduce yourself. So being in spaces like that really taught me, like, all right, do you want to get called out? No? So then get off the wall. Like, just start talking to people. So the next one is networking. So if you like anime, go to Anime Con, go to Comic Con. You'll never know the connections that you can make based off of going to events like this, networking events especially. So this kind of goes in with the last one. With the last one, it's more so figure out what your comfort zone is. Go against that. This one is more so once you get out of your comfort zone a little bit, you are now introduced to people who share the same interests as you. You have more to talk about. You can start friendships based off that. I haven't been to Anime Con or Comic Con, which makes me really sad, but eventually I'm gonna go. Yeah, and you'll never know, like, you could end up in one of those like group chats where you guys can talk about the episodes that you're watching or the animes that you're watching, and you can make really good friendships off of that. Like, depending on the field that you're interested in, so like photographers, models, videographers, whoever you are, when you go to events like that, you can end up meeting so many people that can open so many doors, and y'all could just work together and create something like really magical. Like, you would never know because you're stuck in your room watching, I don't know what you watch. Comment what you watch. Like, I don't know. So yeah, I'd say networking is a very big one, because you can make beautiful friendships, you can make great connections, you can be somewhere different a year from today because of a connection that you made last year. Like, you would never know. Like, in the last year, with people that I've met so many photographers, I've met so many artists, whether it's singers, rappers, painters, designers. Like, a year ago, I was mad shy. Like, I'm still very shy. Like I said in the beginning, like, my anxiety is really bad sometimes, but as far as like putting myself out there and introducing myself to people and trying to make connections, even though my anxiety is like, you have no friends, you have no personality, fall back, I still push myself as much as I can, even if it's just going to the event, saying hi to someone. You can end up with like 10 new friends at the end of the night. That actually happened recently, and I'm happy for that. Shout outs to y'all. Y'all know who you are. The third thing is smiling goes a long way. Now, I know how it sounds. Liz, what are you talking about? But smiling goes a long way. When I first started going to events, I would just like looking mad at the world. And it was like, once I would be like, all right, let me just start smiling just a little bit more. Even if people don't smile back, which is really rude, like, who raised you? Smiling makes you more approachable. So like the hugging the wall thing that I mentioned before makes you less approachable, smiling will make you more approachable because people will want to get to know you, they'll want to get to talk to you, they'll want to introduce themselves to you. Smiling makes you, I read that too, I don't know why I'm coming up with all these, but I read it, that just smiling makes you feel better, even if you're like depressed, the act of smiling makes you feel much better. So smile when you go out. Don't smile at strangers like on the train or like at night, but like if you're at an event or a party or something, y'all get what I'm saying, right? Okay. The fourth one is breathe. Y'all, my anxiety loves to mess with me when I don't think to breathe. Breathing can save you. because y'all seen that clip of Celine Dion when she was doing the breathing exercise? I'm gonna insert it. That be me when I'm anxious, like really bad. So I have to tell myself, like, all right, let's do it together. Let's do it together. Breathing, when you feel like that anxiety is coming to get you, like your nerves are about to get the best of you, breathing will save you. It will, like, when you just do like them self-affirmations, like, yo, I am doing fine, I am great, I am in a beautiful space with beautiful people. This is one thing that helped me a lot. I have nothing to fear. Everyone here is sharing good vibes. Everyone is nice. I have nothing to fear. Breathe. Because why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? Like, I'm me saying this right now is helping me a lot too, because it's like sometimes when I go to events, I'd be scared to talk to people. But it's like when I look back, it's like, why are you afraid? You would never know. Well, maybe you do know the dope personality that you have, the dope energy that you can bring, and the friendships that you can make if you would just breathe, let yourself be open, smile at someone, introduce yourself. Who knows where you'll be a few months into this year? Who knows where you'll be next year? So one more thing. It doesn't happen overnight. Now, we tend to get very frustrated with ourselves when things don't work out in a time that we want them to work out. And we have to remember that things don't happen overnight. So it's gonna take some time. Like I said, with me, the first few events I was going to, I would not talk to anyone. It, like, I had to build up my tolerance. Like, all right, this is how I would approach someone. Maybe I need to smile more. Maybe I need to seem like a little bit more friendly. Maybe I should introduce myself first. You know, maybe I should just compliment someone. As long as you're consistent, then you're gonna be fine. So make sure that you're breathing, make sure that you're smiling, make sure you're not hugging the wall when you go out, and introduce yourself. You know the energy that you have, you know the vibes that you possess, you know your aura attracts others. Don't be afraid. I hope that you take my advice, like I really do, honestly, and I need to take my own advice, like, for the future. But yeah, so those were my 5 tips on how to come out of your shell, even just a little bit. Turtles have to come out of their shell. I'm an aqua turtle, maybe you are too. Turtles have to come out of their shell sometimes, okay? Because we cute, we bomb. Turtles are mad cute, come on. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, if you want more advice videos, comment down below. Yeah, like, comment, and subscribe, and see you in my next video.